You know, when I saw these guys on UVM, a lot of it had to do with the great fans we have here. And they always show up, especially full force for Senior Day. So thanks for being here to honor these great guys. I want to thank our seniors on the dance team, on the cheerleading team. You've been great. Thanks for all your support. And the senior students, congratulations, and thanks for all your support. We're really proud of these guys, not just for being 19-7 tied for first place and all accomplishments on the court, but for carrying themselves in a first-class manner, representing UVM the right way on and off the court. And, they're great guys. We got a lot of memories, just a few little ones I'd like to say that I'll never forget. The win at number 14, Boston College, comes to mind right away. We've had a lot of games on TV. All right, thanks to our administration and the great fans we have. TV cameras love to come in here. The guys have done a great job. We won 12 in a row on Nesson. But when the TV cameras weren't in Hawaii, and we beat an Atlanta 10 team for the first time in program history, and we beat Colorado by 25, the first win against a Big 12 team in team history. Colorado lost overtime to Texas yesterday, so they're a pretty good team.
To win the game, we sort of reverted back to not boxing out, and I thought Stony Brook played a lot tougher than us for most of the game. We obviously had 19 offensive rebounds, and offensively, I didn't think we played real well. Mike and Marcus kept us in the game. We were scoring, we didn't get a whole lot of goals offensively, but even when we started putting up on defense, they'd miss a shot and they'd get an offensive rebound. That was breaking our backs and tiring us out. So, we did enough to find a way to win. We hate to lose such a nice day of Senior Day. But I thought our crowd was great. Solid crowd. They didn't give up on us. And we made enough plays to win. And maybe even pull away. Once again, free throw shooting. Guys are up there missing free throws. And just keeps all the team in the game. So, we had some bad breaks. Ball out of bounds at half court. And I don't think anybody can see the officials. And then another time. Foul the guy, and we stopped down when they saw him, and bailed him out with a foul call. So it's kind of a strange game, a lot of things that I thought kept them in the game when I thought we finally got over the hump. But Gardner made some big plays, and it's nice to see a freshman go up there and make two free throws in a row. So I think he's got a bright future. But I'm happy for our seniors that they went out there. We're recognized by a great crowd, great fans that we have, and I'm happy we escaped. And I was getting sick of losing overtime. I was a little nervous, but I thought the referees, they were going to let him play a little bit for his first play of the game. I think it was a foul. I think they knew it was kind of a blown call, so it seemed like they were going to let us play at the end there. Because they were a good crew. We missed a charge on Elmeen, and then the next time I was going to slide, they gave us a charge. So we kind of make up calls, which good officials do. But I was a little nervous about it, but I was more nervous that we wanted to score first. I wanted to kind of jump on them right away and score. And we were up on three at the other end. So we got to get better play out of some guys in our point guard play. Nick's really having a great first half of the season, struggling for whatever reason. So we got to find out if we can get more out of him. His defense is great. He's struggling on offense and free throw line. I wasn't his normal self today and some other guys, but as a team, we hung in there, and our two best players stepped it up, and that's what they're supposed to do.
I mean, it shows character, and to have three overtime losses is killer. And two of those teams were really tough teams, and just to come out here and to get a win at home with a sold out crowd. I mean, it means a lot, because I think the crowd's going to keep coming back and back when they see us win. When we came out, I think that actually we tried to feed off of it a little bit. with the crowd as much as they were into the game already before even the ball went up. And we went through a 1-3-1, and we were pretty big. We had Marcus hit it too, so we were a pretty big lineup. And I think a 1-3-1 really hurt them at the beginning. We went up 6-0. And I just think from there, they started hitting a couple of threes and everything. But it didn't. I don't think it affected us too much. We tried not to let it. We tried to feed off of it more so.